Welcome back to the Gridiron Expert. We're continuing our Big 12 football predictions today with our next team, the West Virginia Mountaineers. West Virginia is coming off their most successful season since 2011 when they defeated Clemson in the Orange Bowl. Last season, they won 10 games, only lost two in the regular season before getting blown out in their bowl game against Miami. Their only losses came to the top dogs against Oklahoma and Oklahoma State. So it was a very successful season with Dana Holgorsen and the Mountaineers. This season, though, they're one of the most least experienced teams in the Big 12. They only return 8 starters, but what's good for them is that they get a bunch of junior college transfers, and probably the most important factor in this season is they get Will Grier, the transfer quarterback from Florida. He's eligible to play immediately, and I think he's going to give the Mountaineers a huge boost this season. So let's see how they're going to do. They open up the season against Virginia Tech. This is a neutral site game. Neither team has to travel too far. I believe it's going to be played in Maryland, Landover, Maryland. But this is really an intriguing matchup. The old rivals haven't played in a while, so it's going to be fun to watch. Virginia Tech and West Virginia both, I feel, are a little inexperienced, both in their respective conferences. Virginia Tech, some say, are more experienced, especially on the defensive side of the ball. So this could be a battle between West Virginia's offense, which I think is better, will be better than Virginia Tech's. I'm really excited to watch this one. In the end, though, I'm going to give the edge to West Virginia. I'm going to give them the big season-opening victory over the Hokies. That was one that you could really go either way, in my opinion, but right now I'm going to stick with the Mountaineers. I feel more comfortable with them. I think Will Grier is going to make an immediate impact at that quarterback position, and that's going to be huge for them since they only have 5 returning starters on the offensive side of the ball. Remember, though, they do have those junior college transfers. I think they're going to help out on both sides, but I do think their offense will be the strength more so than the defense, which only returns 3 starters. And then they get back-to-back fairly easy games against East Carolina and Delaware State, both at home. Shouldn't be a big problem for West Virginia. Hardest game, obviously, would be East Carolina, but I think they'll take easy care of them. And they're out to a 3-0 start. And then they get Kansas, their first Big 12 game of the season. It's on the road. We saw what happened last year. Kansas has given some teams some trouble when they play at Kansas. TCU comes to mind from last year, and especially Texas when they upset them. I don't think that's going to be an issue for West Virginia this season. Kansas is definitely getting better, especially on the defensive side of the ball. But I think West Virginia is going to have enough to go on the road and defeat the Jayhawks and start off 4-0 going to their bye week. Unfortunately for them, most teams like to come out of a bye week playing at home and against a middle-of-the-pack team or even a low-pack team. But this, unfortunately for West Virginia, they come out of their bye week rested for the TCU game. And that's good. I mean, they're going to be rested for this huge game, but it's on the road, and TCU is a dangerous, dangerous team. And this could, like I said earlier in my TCU video, this could get ugly really fast because of the inexperience on West Virginia's defense and the really good experience of TCU's offense. They returned 10 starters on offense, led by Kenny Hill, Kevontae Turpin, all those guys. And so I really do think that this game could get ugly. I think West Virginia will keep it close. I don't project it to get ugly, but it could. But I do think they're going to go on the road and lose to TCU. I think their offense is just going to be too much for the Mountaineers to handle. And then they get Texas Tech back at home, another team that could have an explosive offense, so they need to watch out for that. But Texas Tech has really struggled of late. They really need to get to a bowl game this season under Cliff Kingsbury. I'm very interested to see if he can get them to a bowl game this season. But with it being at West Virginia, with Texas Tech, we really don't know much about them. Their key this season, if they want to win games, it's going to be their defense. We know their offense can put up points, but can the defense prevent them? I don't think they're going to be able to prevent them against West Virginia. And I want to give West Virginia the win there. And then this is another, these next two games I really did struggle with, at Baylor and Oklahoma State. We already know a lot about Oklahoma State. They're going to be very experienced this year. 12 returning starters, probably one of the better quarterbacks in the conference, maybe in the country, led by Mason Rudolph, James Washington at wide receiver. That dynamic duo there is going to give defense some fits. But we'll start with the Baylor game, a team that we don't know that much about, led by Matt Rhule, coming in from Temple. As you saw in my Baylor video, I said he's going to try to turn them into a more of a pro-styled offense, which really is not what Baylor has been used to previously when they were under Art Briles. West Virginia is going on the road for this one, and I think it's later in the season. It's about mid, late October. I think Baylor will figure stuff out. They would have adapted by this point. Now, I'm going to predict a minor upset and give Baylor the win over the Mountaineers. This was a game I struggled with. Really, it was because I don't know a lot about Baylor. None of us know a lot about Baylor and how they're going to react. They don't have a lot of starters returning. And with the new change on offense and everything, with the new head coach, I think they're going to take a major step back from what we've been used to, seeing them win 11 games, 10-11 games. But right now, I'm going to give West Virginia the loss. But another game that could draw some controversy, I'm going to give them the win at home over Oklahoma State. I think they're going to want to bounce back from that loss. Oklahoma State could be riding high, might overlook West Virginia, because I mean they're doing good right now. They're 5-2, but I think West Virginia is going to get the upset over the Cowboys. I think their defense is going to be fired up, and I think Will Grier is going to be able to hang with them. Oklahoma State's defense is also going to be their weak point. I think we know their offense is going to be good. Same with West Virginia. I think their offense will be just fine. I think they're going to be able to put up enough points over the Cowboys. This was another one of those toss-up games for me that I really did struggle with. But in the end, I decided to give the Mountaineers the win over the Cowboys at home. And then they get Iowa State at home, another game. That'll be huge for them. Shouldn't be that bad, though. And then they need to win this. They don't need to take a step back after such a huge win over a potential top 10 or top 15 Oklahoma State team. I think they'll get the win over the Cyclones, especially since it's at home. If it was on the road, I would have thought about it a little longer. Because, Iowa State does play well at home, but they're going to get the win there. Still looking very strong. They are at 7-2 going into their final three games. But look at that stretch there. At Kansas State, Texas at home, and at Oklahoma. So three very tough Big 12 opponents there. We'll start with Kansas State, led by Jesse Ertz, the dual threat quarterback, who a lot of people think could do great things. A lot of people think could not live up to his potential. Bill Snyder, though, always gets the best out of his teams. Kansas State is probably, if you watch my video of them, is out of Big 12 title contention at this point. But I still think they have a lot to play for, potential 9, maybe 10 win season. And I'm going to give West Virginia the loss here on the road to the Wildcats. I think the Wildcats are a very dangerous team. Could surprise a lot of people in this Big 12, and people don't need to overlook them. And I think in the end, with those 14 returning stars at Kansas State, they're going to be too much for the Mountaineers. And then they get Texas at home. Another tough game. Tom Herman's going to have this Texas team fired up. By this point, Texas would have already clinched a bowl berth if you watch my Texas video. But their offense is going to be good, more so on the defensive side of the ball, though, with those 10 returning starters. West Virginia gets them at home, though. And I think they're going to get the win late over Texas, a late season win. This game will come down to the wire. I think it's going to be very close. But as I said in my Texas video, weather could play a factor. It's late November. We saw that weather in the Oklahoma game from last season. It was snowing. If that's the case here, Texas won't be used to that. I'm not saying that's the only reason I'm picking a Texas loss, but I'm going to give West Virginia the win there. I really do think Will Grier is going to be able to get some defense and fits this season. And then at Oklahoma, really, if West Virginia could pull off the upset over two of these teams, Baylor, Kansas State, or TCU, they would potential. This could be playing for the Big 12 championship, getting into that spot, at least for West Virginia. It's at Oklahoma, though, led by Baker Mayfield and Lincoln Riley, the new head coach, who was the offensive coordinator, so I don't think they're going to take any steps back there. I'm predicting a late-season loss for West Virginia in the final game for the Mountaineers, and that's going to give them an 8-4 record on the season. So it's a minor step back from a team that went 10-2 in the regular season. So really a two-game drop, which I think should be expected from Mountaineer fans. I don't think they're going to win double-digit games again this season just because of the inexperience they have. Will Grier is going to play a huge role, but I think 8-4 is reasonable. They'll go to another decent bowl game, so it is something to be excited about with Mountaineer fans. Considering the long line success, they went 4-8 a couple years ago, 7-6, got to 8 wins, finally got to 10 wins. So they're taking a minor step back, shouldn't be a big deal. Toss-up games, though, as you heard me say, the Baylor game, Oklahoma State, and Virginia Tech. I'm actually giving them the edge in my toss-up games, 2-1 more so, because I'm giving them the win over Virginia Tech and Oklahoma State. Those could easily be losses, and we could be looking at a 6-6 season for West Virginia. But right now, I want to keep them an 8-4. I feel pretty confident about that, and I'm very excited to see what this team can do. I think Dana Holgorsen is going to get the best out of his team. The offense is going to surprise, even though they only have 5 stars back, and the junior college players are going to play a huge role this season since they are very inexperienced on both sides of the ball. So keep an eye on the Mountaineers this season. They could surprise. Please continue to like, comment, subscribe, and please continue to share our videos, and we'll see you next time on The Gridiron Expert.